We gather in the beautiful Honan Chapel this morning on this wonderful November morning and give thanks for deceased staff members and students who've died in the past year. The UCC community has experienced the loss of 25 members during the past year. In many traditions, November is a month of remembrance, a time of reflection. While it is sadness that we mourn the loss of our colleagues and friends and our wonderful students, it is also with gratitude that we give thanks for their extraordinary contribution to this institution. Not only have we, hopefully we changed their lives while they were here, but you certainly have changed our lives by your engagement, by your contribution, by being you. Also today, we're pausing to remember in a special way all those of the UCC family who've been affected by the pandemic. It's not necessarily over yet, but hopefully we're through the most difficult period of it. It has impacted on all our lives in the last period. And as part of the remembrance, I'd be delighted to join the president of the Students' Union in opening a book of intentions for staff and students to enter their thoughts, reflections, prayers and intentions as we mark what has been an extraordinarily turbulent time in our world, and certainly in this institution in its 177 years. It's had a deep impact on our community, some of it negative, much of it negative, but hopefully also positive insofar as that we can see our interdependence on each other, the extent to which we rely on each other to support during these really difficult times. And we saw extraordinary evidence of this, where generosity beyond anything we'd ever perhaps seen before. And perhaps that moment of reflection to refresh that sense of support for each other, affection and love that we've seen perhaps less in recent years. Many of the UCC community were affected by either loss or illness, which we also acknowledge today. Many too were in the front line. And I'm thinking of everybody in this institution, whether you opened a gate to let somebody in, whether you served a meal, whether you worked in the library, whether you're a front-facing student, whether you're a student supporting students, whether you're in the chaplaincy, wherever your role is, you've done an extraordinary amount of work in the last year. We thank you for it, and we also salute you for the extraordinary work that you have done during this pandemic period. Today we give thanks also for the collective effort of the university in this task, and the Book of Intentions, which I will sign with President of Students' Union, will open until the end of December, and will have an opportunity to sign it virtually yourself. University College Cork is proud of its very many values, but in particular the value of respect for all who serve this institution, respect for different voices, respect for diversity. We're immensely grateful for their contribution to staff and students that make to our university and supporting these values, but also in supporting all our students and indeed their families. We acknowledge and thank them and know that they will be continually remembered for their generosity, kindness, and the impact they've had on our lives. May they rest in peace. Finally, I want to just particularly thank our chaplaincy team, who, no different from the rest of us, suffered and struggled, perhaps were sick, perhaps lost loved ones. And yet I and the university community called upon you to support us, to support us as a community at a time when we needed your comfort, your consolation. And perhaps you were lonely yourself. Perhaps you felt isolated yourself. You as chaplaincy team here at University College Cork are an extraordinary group of colleagues that enable our students and our staff to be supported, to feel valued, and to feel special at perhaps the most vulnerable times of their lives. And I know we're all human, and I'm sure there were moments for each of you where you felt, my goodness, this is hard for me to do. So we salute you, we thank you, and we say Míle Buíochas. May all those we've lost during the year rest in peace.
On behalf of the chaplaincy team in UCC, I warmly welcome you to this recording of our annual remembrance event for our staff and students who have died during the past 12 months. This year also, because we are coming, we hope, to the end of pandemic, we're taking an opportunity to remember those who have been affected in our community, those who have died, and also those who have been on the front line assisting with the pandemic. A warm welcome to you. And we take this moment when the university pauses to stop to remember all our deceased loved ones.
Cadé le liam omrhile. Táim o hiomra go siomra ar fud an tí ag lorg rodégin. Is nach megis agam, cadé no go bhaime é. Ní hé an stán aráin é an plúr garbh daun ná an plúr mín bán. Cé go dógam amach iad, is go gudim sa bheith iad, is go ninim bulín a bhain. Ní hé an leabhar a bhíos a léibhé, más bún mo chuoine is a leagas uaim. Cé go seasaím ag na sealfaine, is go bhéacham tríthe, is go déim ar mo ghlúine ar an urlár. Ní hé an ochar a bhí uaimí, ní rása dul amach, ní ar agus aon ar siúl. Cé go bhfuilim ó seomra go seomra ar fud an tí ag lorg rud éigin is nach faice, is go bhfuilim ag déanamh broin thiúin.
From the book of Ecclesiastes, there's a time for everything and a season for every activity under the heavens. A time to be born and a time to die. A time to plant and a time to uproot. A time to kill and a time to heal. A time to tear down and a time to build. A time to weep and a time to laugh. A time to mourn and a time to dance. A time to scatter stones and a time to gather them. A time to embrace and a time to refrain from embracing. A time to search and a time to give away. A time to keep and a time to throw away. A time to tear and a time to mend. A time to be silent and a time to speak. A time to love and a time to hate. A time for war and a time for peace.
From St. Matthew's Gospel. Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are they who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the land. Blessed are they who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be satisfied. Blessed are the merciful, for they will be shown mercy. Blessed are the clean of heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God.
As well as the annual remembrance of those within the UCC community who have died, this year we also remember those who were affected by the corona pandemic. We remember those known to us who have died, those who suffered, and the many who continue to suffer from its effects. And we give thanks for all those who served our communities through healthcare, in vital industries and services, and those who cared for others as family, friends and neighbours. Few communities will have been unaffected by loss, illness and health throughout the pandemic. The feeling of fear and anxiety has been present in households and within communities. And in our remembering today, we acknowledge the pain and heartbreak so many have experienced. We also give thanks and acknowledge the contribution of carers and key workers who have given themselves sacrificially during the pandemic, recognizing as a community that this needs to be honored, celebrated, and remembered for more than just a season. A third element post-pandemic is restoration. It gives the opportunity to celebrate the rediscovery of the importance of the local community, the resurgence of kindness and the helping of neighbours. As our lives return to some kind of normality, we must not let the work done by so many be taken for granted. We, as members of society, owe a great debt to all that has been done, and we need to uphold the value of the people who served us in so many vital ways, and not allow that to be forgotten as we journey into the future. We need to challenge ourselves to ask, what value do we put on the service of such people? And ask whether this is truly acknowledged and rewarded within our communities. So today we pause, as individuals within the community of our university, to remember, to lament, to give thanks, and to reflect on what we would wish for the future, to draw strength from the memories of those who have gone before us and all that they have shared with us, to acknowledge the pain and suffering of so many during the pandemic, to give thanks for the example of so much selfless service given by so many. And as we look to the future of our lives, as individuals and as a community, to challenge ourselves to see what construct we would hope to build and to pledge ourselves to that future.
Father in heaven, we thank you because you made us in your own image and gave us gifts in mind, body, and spirit. We give you thanks for all those who have been part of our university community, but who have sadly died this year. As we honor their memory, make us more aware that you are the one from whom comes every perfect gift, including the gift of eternal life through Jesus Christ. Lord, hear us. Gracious God, surround us and all who mourn with your continuing compassion. Do not let grief overwhelm us or sorrow overpower us, but enable us to continue one step at a time along your road of death and resurrection. Lord, hear us. We give you thanks for the gift of scholarship and inquiry, for the search for meaning and truth, for the students and staff of University College Cork, and for its president, Professor John O'Halloran. Lord, hear us. Keep us, good Lord, under the shelter of your mercy. In this time of uncertainty and distress, sustain and support the anxious and fearful, and lift up all those who have been brought low through the recent pandemic, that we may rejoice in your comfort, knowing that nothing can separate us from your love. Lord, hear us.
With gratitude and affection, we remember the members of the UCC community, staff and students who have died in the past year. Mr. John Joseph Milan, formerly of General Services Department, 23rd of January, 2022. Dr. Moira O'Donovan, School of Nursing and Midwifery, 2nd of February, 2022. Mr. Lauros Whelan, ACE, Mental Health in the Community Student, 13th of February, 2022. Mr. Jamie Landers, 4th year BSc Finance Student, 14th of February, 2022. Mr. Peter Kelly, Springboard Plus Certificate in Operator Development Student, 26th of February, 2022. Mr. Donal O'Leary, formerly of Department of Chemistry, 26th of February 2022. Professor John A. Murphy, Emeritus Professor of History, 27th of February 2022. Mr. William Britton, MSc Applied Environmental Geoscience student, 17th of March 2022. Dr. Will Brady, UCC Centre for Planning, Education and Research, 13th of April 2022. Mr. Bart Bambury, Brookfield Library, 30th of April 2022. Mr. Paul Morrissey, MA Applied Psychology, Positive and Coaching Psychology student, 14th of May 2022. Mr. Paul Keegan, formerly of School of Mathematical Sciences, the 18th of May 2022. Professor Martin O'Fahig, former Director of ACE, 3rd of June 2022. Ms. Claire Goggin, formerly of UCC Library, 12th of June 2022. Ms. Callahan, formerly of Department of Italian, 23rd of June 2022. Ms. Helen Kinsley, formerly of Secretarial Centre, 25th of June 2022. Mr. Derry Murray, formerly of UCC Printing Office, the 24th of July, 2022. Ms. Aoife Murphy, formerly of the Departments of Theatre and Music, 4th of August, 2022. Mr. Donal Harris, formerly of Department of Anatomy, the 18th of August, 2022. Ms. Eileen Fahilly, formerly of President's Office, 12th of September 2022. Ms. Gertrude Ahern, formerly of Boole Library, 17th of September 2022. Sister Eleanor O'Leary, formerly of School of Applied Psychology, 9th of October 2022. Mr. Derry Carney, formerly of Department of Chemistry, 25th of October, 2022. Mr. Pat Harrington, formerly of Buildings and Estates Office, 30th of October, 2022. Dr. Michelle Cronin, MARAI, 4th of November, 2022.
Thank you for joining us for the annual remembrance event in honour of those of our UCC community who have died during the past year. As UCC SU President, it is my privilege to pay tribute to those who have died, particularly those students who are sadly no longer with us. We are a close college community that seeks not just to be true to our mission to change lives through education, but also to support one another. We are aware that the legacy that each staff member and student leaves on this university is one that is orientated always towards the common good. We have been privileged to share their lives, their hopes, and their dreams. While sadness is always part of remembrance, gratitude is too. We're thankful for their legacy and the impression made by them on the life of UCC. We are conscious too of the effect over the past 2 years of the pandemic and the disruption it has caused. We are well aware that our university community was affected in many ways through the death of loved ones. It is right that we recognise this as we appear to come to the end of this period of difficulty for so many. We are also aware of the many people in the university who were at the forefront of care, science, and part of the national frontline response. We're extremely grateful for them. I ask you to join with me in remembering all these people by taking a moment over the next few weeks to leave messages of condolence and support for all those affected by the pandemic. Again, as UCC Students' Union President, I particularly want to pay tribute to students who are sadly no longer with us. When a student comes to UCC, for many, UCC becomes their home away from home, and their classmates and their friends that they make become their second family. The loss of a student is one that is felt by their peers, their classmates, their friends, their housemates, and the staff who teach them. But of course, it is most felt by their family at home. I ask you all to join me in remembering them. May all our deceased staff and students rest in peace.